they were taking a deep dive into the engine rooms of Elite Dangerous. And I'm going to tell you everything you could possibly want to know about shields, and then some. We all strive for the best possible gaming experience, but the importance of a good quality chair is often underestimated. Secret Lab produces some of the most comfortable and high quality gaming chairs you can get, so upgrade your Commander chair today and fly in style and comfort worthy of the Imperial Cutter. Follow the link in the video description to their store, type in your height, your weight, and it will tell you which chairs fit you for the best possible seating experience. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to what will most likely be one of the nerdiest Elite Dangerous video I have ever done. And that is no small feat, because I've done some pretty nerdy Elite Dangerous videos. We're going to go into a absurd amount of details about how shields work. We're going to look at how resistances, how hit points are calculated, and I'm going to show you some real example with some real builds where we're going to try to run through the math, how the resistances and how the hit points have been calculated behind the scenes. So if you're interested in getting some background information about how shields in particular work, then you should definitely stick around. But before we start, I want to give you a basic introduction to the mechanics of shields. This is just to get everybody on the same page. Now, as many of you will probably know, if we go in here and we take a look at some shield generators. Shield generators are completely separate from shield boosters. Mathematically, they are two distinctly different things. They almost work as two separate shields in the way they're calculated, at least, where the resistances on one and the resistances on the other are completely separate. And again, at the end, what happens is the shield boosters themselves are just adding a modifier to the main shield at the end after all, like diminishing return, all the stuff has been calculated. We've got to come back to that. So what I want to start with is just give you a quick overview of how your base hit points are calculated, or what I should probably call your modified base hit points, because every ship have a base shield strength. This is a hidden stat that we cannot see. It can be calculated, but it's not shown anywhere. What you can see in your ship statistics is the modified base shield. So if you have no shield boosters fitted, then what you will see is your shield health. That is your modified base shield. And that is determined by the four stats here on a shield generator called the minimum mass, the optimal mass, the maximum mass, the minimum strength, optimal strength, and maximum strength. Now notice here that it says hull mass. This is because it's only the hull of the ship that counts towards this. Equipment does not count when it comes to generating shield hit points. Now, the minimum mass is at which point, if you go lower than the minimum mass, your shield will still work, but you're not going to gain anything higher. That is the at the minimum mass, you get the maximum strength that a given shield booster, a shield generator, I should say, can produce. At the maximum mass, you're going to get the minimum. And of course, at the optimal, you get the optimal. So it's not like you have to aim for the optimal. That's actually better to aim for the minimum. But again, this is just to kind of give an idea about how this is generated. Now again, the formula behind this is a little vague, and I haven't been able to like 100% reproduce it, but there is a forum thread where one of the developers go over it in quite a bit of detail. But the formula he lists over there has either been changed since, or at least I couldn't get it to reproduce the results that I see in game. So all the shield generator does is it, depending on how heavy your ship is, it adds a modifier to your base shield. And the modifiers here, they change, and the hulls here change depending on what shield generator you get. Now the masses here, the minimum, optimal, and maximum hull mass, they do not change as long as you're within the same class of module. That means as long as you're keeping to a class 7, these will always be the same. So you can see here we have, if you try to keep in mind of these numbers here, if we take another one, let's just for instance take the 7D rate and let's look at that. You can see the hull masses here are the same, but the strength has changed. So in this situation here, before we had 70, 120, and 170, now we're down to 40, 90, and 140. So we can see we get less of a multiplier on our base shield for the same hull mass. So our modified base shield is going to be different. This is also why that shields like the Bi-Weave, for instance, has a overall lower hit points. First of all, because it's classified as a C rate, but even within, if you compare it to another C rate, you can see standard C rated shield booster or shield generator has 50, 100, and 150 in shield strength bonuses. But if you go to a Bi-Weave, you're down to 40, 90, and 40. So the same as you got on a D rated. It's the exact same thing if we go, and I can quickly here just go and find a 7A prismatic shield generator. Whoops, not cell. There we go. We're up to 100, 150, and 200. And we recall before, I think this was 70, 120, and 170 on a non-prismatic. So that's why you can see you're getting more shield out of prismatics, because the strengths are the same while the masses, again, the strengths are higher while the masses stay the same, is what I'm trying to say. And of course, if you go down the rate, so if you go down to, let's say, a 6A, for instance, and take a look at the stats on that one, you will see the strength bonuses are the same as you could got on a 7A. But of course, the masses have dropped, meaning if you fit this to your ship, you will be closer to the maximum hull mass, and thereby you will be pulled closer to the minimum shield strength bonus you get, and therefore you will get less shield. So there's actually no hard hit points in the shield generators themselves. It's purely just modifiers on top of your base shields. And of course, then when you have your modified base shields, which I, for the rest of this video, will just be referring to as your base shield, that is then being modified by the shield boosters. And of course, if you have engineering on your shield generator, then that will alter these values somehow, that will then give you another modified base shield. Let's start by doing an example where we look at how hit points are calculated and how shield boosters are stacking. So let's take an example here, and let's imagine that we have a ship that has a shield generator on it, and the modified base shield is 100 hit points. This is just for an example, and 100 is easy to calculate with. And let's then say that we add a single 0A shield booster without any engineering. That's going to give us a 20% increase in our hit points. So we take the base, we add 20%, and we come up with 120 hit points. Now, if we add a second booster, the total boost is now up to 40%, because the shield boosters, when it comes to shield health, this is only health, by the way, when it comes to shield health, they stack additively with each other, but multiplicatively with the shield generator. So that means when you add two shield boosters with 20% each, you just add the two together, that gives you 40%, so you add 40% on top. So what you can see here is that this kind of a, it's not actually a diminishing return, because they still give you the 20% every time. But because they are stacking additively with each other and not multiplicatively with each other, that is kind of a mathematical hidden diminishing return. As you begin to add more and more of them, the percentage increase you will get from the last one is going to be smaller. Okay, let's try to do a real life example where we actually calculate the shield hit points that you should be getting out of your ship. So, first of all, what we want to do is we want to first find out what is my current ship's modified base shield. So what I will have to do is I'll have to go in and I'll turn off all my shield boosters, because we want to see what the base shield is before shield boosters are added. Then we're going to go over and we're going to try to calculate what the shield strength should be. Now one thing that's important to note is the Guardian Shield Reinforcement Packs. These add a flat bonus. If we go in here and have a quick look at the stats, you can see that these gives a shield reinforcement bonus and not a shield boost bonus. Now, shield reinforcement bonuses are added after bonuses from shield boosters are added. So the order in which things are applied is that you get the base shield, modified base shield out of your shield generator, you add the bonus from the shield boosters, and then you add the bonus from the Guardian Shield Reinforcement Packs. But however, they are affected by the resistances you get from the shield boosters, because resistances are calculated afterward. So what I will also have to do is I'll have to go and I'll have to get rid of these. I can't for some reason deactivate them, so I'll just quickly remove these from the ship. While we're in here in the outfitting anyway, I just quickly want to show you what shield boosters I have fitted to the ship. It's not really important whether it's a good build or a bad build, this is just an example. So as this example here, I have two heavy duty, and we can see these both give a shield boost of 73.9%. Then I have some augmented resistance, and I have a single kinetic resistance shield booster, but these all give 26% shield boost. I have seven fitted in total, so that is 5 with 26% and 2 with 75.9% increase. So now that we have everything unfitted, and we just quickly confirm that all our shield boosters are in fact deactivated, we can go to a ship, go down to the statistics, and we can now see the ship health here. Because we have no shield boosters active with no guardian reinforcements, our base shield now is 572 hit points. Okay, so I prepared a quick spreadsheet here that we can take a look at. And you can see here that I've written all the shield boosters that we have up here, just written in the stats so far. So we have the heavy duties, we have two of those, we have the resistance augmented, four of those, and we have a kinetic, one of those, and we have our base shield. So the first thing we do is that we calculate the total bonus, so we just sum up the bonuses we got from all the shield boosters. So we just take that and multiply it by the number we have, and then we add it up with that, and we can then multiply that by just type in 5, because I can make 1 and 4 together in my head. There we go. So the total bonus we get from our shield boosters is 277.8%. Of course, we have to add that up. We need to add 1 to it to make it, because we're going to multiply it with the, we're going to add 277%, so we need the 100% that's already there. So we're going to go 1 plus, and then we're going to add that one there. So this is our modifier that we're going to get out of the shield boosters. We're going to get a modifier 3.778. So if we go ahead and we say base shield and multiply it by the modifier, we end up at 2,161 hit points. So let's jump back in game. Let's turn all the shield boosters on. Let's see what we get. Okay, here you can see all shield boosters are now active again. And if we go over to the stats, you can see we are at 2,159. So we had 2 hit points off what it should be. And I think that's just down to rounding errors. There will be like minute rounding errors here and there. But that's pretty damn close. And I've been trying this with many different combinations of shield boosters. And I'm always within 1 or 2 hit points of what you actually get in game. So that is how simple it is. And note here, that actually surprised me a lot, that there's no diminishing return on hit points. There's no stacking penalty for just keep adding more and more shield boosters. You get the bonus you get. The diminishing return is kind of hidden in the mathematics, the fact that the 8th one, the more you put, the less percentage increase it will give compared to what you got with the previous one. So what happens with resistances is that the resistances is kind of translated from a resistance over to a damage multiplier. So it's kind of a number you multiply the damage with in order to accommodate that resistance that it had. We're going to go through a real life example again here in a bit, but I just want to give you a general overview of how it works. So you take those modifiers and you keep modifying them to each other. So here, instead of adding them up additively, we're now adding the modifiers multiplicatively. So we're multiplying them together. And that means that you will start with a damage multiplier of 1. That is no resistance. That means 100% of the damage are going straight through. As you add more multipliers, the multiplier will begin to go down. The lower the multiplier, the less damage will go through. And remember, right now we're just talking about the shield booster part. We are not talking about the shield generator. This is just boosters. So you take all those modifiers, you keep adding them together. But when you've added enough of these, when you get down, below a multiplier of 0.7, you'll begin to experience diminishing return. And everything you have below 0.7 of damage multiplier will be halved, and you won't get half the effect of it. So that means you have like a 30% area at the top where you get 100% effectiveness out of your resistance. And as you then move down lower, you get into the area here marked in yellow, which is then the diminishing return area. Now that could be a little difficult maybe to understand just from that, but let's try to do this in a real life example. What I have here is just the base kinetic resistance of of the cube combo build that we just looked at before. We have we have 2 heavy duties that has a -2% kinetic resistance. Then we have 4 resistance augmented with 15.3% kinetic resistance, and we have a single kinetic resistance shield booster with 25.5% kinetic resistance. So the first step will be to convert these from resistances over to modifiers. We're going to convert this back and forth. Let's start with the 25.5% one, because it's probably the one that's easiest to understand. So if we're removing 25.5% of all damage, that must mean that the modifier is just 1 minus the resistance, right? So that means we should get 74.5% of damage going through. We're kind of flipping the whole thing around. So instead of having resistance showing how much damage is blocked, it's now showing how much damage goes through. So it's kind of the opposite of resistance, right? And we can easily calculate back and forth between them by just subtracting 1. Or subtracting it from 1, I should say. So we can do that, and we can do that for the 2 others as well. Of course, when we do up here, we get a multiplier higher than one because we have a negative resistance, right? So these are our modifiers for the different shield generators. So the first thing we want to do is we want to just multiply all these modifiers together. So we're going to take the heavy duty one. We need to do that two times. So to simplify things, we're just going to raise that. Raise that to the power of 2. Then we're going to multiply it with the kinetic modifiers, raised to the power of 4 because we are 4 fitted. Multiply that with the multiplier from the kinetic resistance one to the power of 1. Power of 1 doesn't do anything, but just for consistency's sake, we're going to add that as well. That gives us a no diminishing. So this is no DR because we have no diminishing return right now calculated into this. So the first thing we have to do is we need to calculate how much of this modifier is in that yellow zone. Remember before when we had the bar set down to 0.7, that's the green zone with no diminishing return. The yellow part, that is the part that is affected by diminishing return. So we need to calculate how much of it is in the yellow zone, which we do quite simply by just saying 0.7. And then we subtract the non-diminishing return modifier, and we get the amount, about 30% is in the diminishing return area. And as I said, in there we only get half the effect. That means we can take that resistance we get in the diminishing return area, divide it by 2, and then we have about 15%, of course. So now we can calculate our effective bonus coming out of all our 7 shield boosters with diminishing return compensation. We do that by again take 0.7, and we then subtract the new bonus. So if I subtract this one, I would get back to the original number that I had up here. But instead of using that one, I'll be using the next one here where we have compensated for diminishing return. And here we have our true modifier that we get out of our shield boosters. Now, next step is to apply this to the shield generator. Now, in my case, the shield generator I have fitted has 26.9% kinetic resistance. So just as before, we're going to take that and we're going to convert that over to a modifier. Just drag that down. There we go. So again, just as we did with the boosters, we're going to take the resistance on the shield generator, convert it over to a modifier. And then we're going to calculate the total modifier that we gain from both the shield generator and the shield boosters. We do that by multiplying the modifier from the shield boosters, compensated for diminishing return, and multiplied by the modifier from the shield generator. And that is our final modifier, which we can then again convert back into a resistance rather than a modifier by saying 1 minus the modifier. And we end up with a 59.8 resistance to kinetic. So let's hit in game. Let's see if I was right. Just quickly verifying that all my shield boosters are in fact active. Head over to the ship. And we end up, you can see here, kinetic resistance at, here's 59.9, not 0.8. Again, there's some rounding errors. I mean, we only have, I believe it's 2 decimal places. But I think the game actually uses more decimal places behind the scenes. It's just only displaying 2. So we will have some rounding errors. And now, of course, it's been rounded up to just 1 decimal place. So there are a little bit of rounding errors, just as we had with the shield health. But again, I've done this for a variety of different builds and loadouts and tried it out. And it is solid. It comes out with a correct result pretty much every single time. At least every single time I've done it. So how do you take all this and implement this into your everyday builds? Well, to be honest, unless you really like to sit and tinker and do number crunching, it's probably very difficult to implement into your builds. So why have I done it? You see, what I'm doing right now is I'm working on a program that will take every possible combinations of shield booster and shield generator engineering and experimental effects, which is well in excess of like several 100,000 different builds. And they're going to compute the resistances, the shield health, and then it's going to figure out which build is the potentially best combination of different engineering modifications in various situations. It's going to take a while to calculate that, but the idea is that I want to basically go through every possible build you can make in Elite and figure out which is best in which situations. So if you want the result of that, where that program is done and I've run that analysis, you should stay tuned to the channel. There's a link below where you can subscribe to the channel, and well, if you really want those information as soon as they come out, there's also a bell icon. If you want to keep supporting the channel and keep these kind of in-depth videos coming and allowing me to keep doing these kind of projects, there's also a link for Patreon or the merch store where you can go down and support the channel either like directly through Patreon or by buying some merchandise. I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give it a like, and I'll see you next time. I'll see you guys in space.